Hi, welcome to Green Biz Studio. My name is Sarah Golden. I'm the Senior Energy Analyst at Green Biz. I'm joined today in the studio with Asim Tahir from Google. Asim, tell me what you do at Google.
Thank you very much for having me. I lead district and energy strategy for our campus development projects. And as we're growing from looking at individual buildings to increasing our footprint, we're really looking at how we combine systems for multiple buildings to do additional resource recovery and increase the overall circularity of our campus.
So what kind of initiatives and projects are you working on right now?
So one of the things we've really looked at, how do we combine heating and cooling of buildings and recover heat from one building, provide it to the other, and essentially take out natural gas for heating purposes. We implemented a project using geoenergy piles that give us confidence that this can actually work for our campus, and we're now looking at expanding that to additional buildings that are under design and looking at thermal storage as a way of recovering heating and cooling at different times of year and different times of day.
That's an amazing challenge. I know in California, one of the biggest challenges we have right now is addressing how to get natural gas out of buildings and the way that we're using it. What kind of challenges have you guys been running into as you've been trying to take this on?
There are really, I would say, three broad categories. Initially, it's regulatory. When you're trying, district systems themselves are not new, but implementing them in a commercial space where you have public rights of ways and crossings, the existing regulations present some hurdles that we need to figure out a way to overcome. The second is around implementation. Some of the newer technologies, they're not very commonly understood, so there's a lot of work that needs to be done for sharing knowledge between organizations that have done it and really invest more in the sustainable workforce of the future with job training programs and get people more familiar with these so you don't have fear of the unknown. And the third, really, I would say, is imagination. In design, typically things are done in silos. And if we want a different outcome, we can't keep doing the same thing. We have to really start thinking about integrated design and really find holistic ways of making systems support one another. The architecture needs to support the systems. The system needs to support the architecture.
So what advice would you have for other people at other companies that are interested in implementing something like this? Who should they be talking to? How can they be tapping into the knowledge that companies like Google have already unearthed?
I think it's the knowledge is there. One of the things that perhaps hampers folks is unfamiliarity. So there is a good power of precedent. We all want to have a 10x impact, but sometimes it's important to start small. So before we did these projects, we did smaller pilot projects of the individual technology components. So when we were putting it all together at a large scale, we had actually gotten over a lot of that concern of unfamiliarity. We knew that these things work individually, and we just had to make the case of putting them together and showing the positive value. And in that way, really, you can overcome a lot of the uncertainty whether these things would work or not. As far as technologies, most of the engineering firms that think about these things are very, very knowledgeable. These technologies are implemented on university campuses, institutional clients have them. Many of these technologies are implemented in Europe for a number of years. I think in North America, there's a challenge that they haven't taken up that much. So when we were looking at some of these things, we actually traveled. We went to precedent projects. We talked to the operations teams, tried to understand whether the original intent of the design was actually being met. Were they underperforming, overperforming? What kind of things did they find out that you could not conceive of during design? And that gave us a lot of confidence in really going forward with it and learn from the others to actually correct any mistakes that we could have made otherwise. So I would say that would be advice for anybody.
Well, Asim, thank you so much for joining us today in Green Biz Studios and sharing your story with us.
Thank you very much.